What if I told you the hair you've been braiding years after years might be poisoning you? I'm not being dramatic, I'm being real.
Funny, yes, but not funny, haha.
But
funny, yes, but not funny, haha.
Unfortunately, the fibroids are back.
So we are looking at endocrine disruptors, issues for women which include fertility, endometriosis. We are looking at fibroids, nervous system destruction. That's the poison hidden in synthetic hair. In case you're still wearing it, we've got to talk. Hi everyone! 3 days back, I watched this woman here tell women of color, tell black women that actually synthetic hair isn't bad for them. And she really triggered me. I couldn't sleep. I was so mad that I really had to come back here and make this video. It's interesting. I was talking actually to a friend of mine who told me that I should leave IT completely and choose a different career that has something to deal with saving the world, saving people. I don't know about that, but one thing for sure, I do care about my people. There are certain things that really trigger me. There are certain things that I'm really passionate about, and honestly this video is one of them. So, but if you're one of the people that wears synthetic hair, I've done that over and over. I used to ignore the headaches, the itching, even the burning. I thought, oh, okay, it's just irritation for the whole week. And I know most of you have gone through this and you're like, no, but your skin is screaming that actually whatever you're putting on my body, okay, whatever you're putting on your body is not safe, it's actually causing harm. But you're like, no, it's something else.
Oh dear me, guys, a dilemma of a woman of color of today, hair. I did braid this hair. Oh my goodness, how many times have you seen a woman do this? This is the dilemma. I did this hair 4 days ago. Honestly, I think I'm gonna remove it by Friday. I did all the other tricks people say, like put it in apple cider vinegar, like leave it for an hour and then afterwards get it out and then you're good to go. But I can't tell you, this hair has been itching. The first day I put it, actually I wanted to remove it immediately, but I didn't have that that luxury because like this whole week I've been busy. And I can show you that my scalp is really clean. It's not like my hair is dirty. No, it's not dirty. This hair, my God. I swear. I can't wait for tomorrow to remove it.
But I'm telling you that it's not just an irritation. It's something hidden that we've been really ignoring for too long. But now it's time to talk about it and actually discover the cause of our problems. Because when you look at data today, African women, women of color, and African American women got the highest number of fibroids. And you know how they come around? Environmental toxins and hormonal imbalance. And you know what causes that? Part of what I'm talking about, synthetic hair. But I didn't actually decide on a single day that let me stop using it. I made so many excuses until one day I looked at the data and I would never go back. I don't know if you've seen it, but most of the hair today that we see on the market is made from 100% kanikaron. Don't take my word for it. But let me take you to my PC and we look at data. And we're gonna go at the website right now. So if you come to their page, you can see they provide the fibers mostly, I think, to make hair. So let's scroll down and see what actually their fiber is made from. You can see their fiber is compositive monochromatic fiber, and then you can see here they have an advantage of polyvinyl chloride fiber. Oh my god. And to add on that, you can really see here it's flame retardant. The chemicals that are used to make it flame retardant. Just do a Google research, just a little bit of it. Dangers, the flame retardant fibers. Oh my God, I'm not kidding you, but I can't imagine we have been blind so much. It's incredible how people think this is okay for us. And not even to take you very far, let's talk about polyvinyl chloride fiber, which is a fiber that is made from vinyl chloride, a dangerous gas chemical that is actually banned in Europe. And I'm going to take you to the page, it's banned in all cosmetics. Actually, at the end of the day, I don't even need to convince you. After looking at all this data and you decide, well, I want to use synthetic hair, please go ahead. For me, right now, it's more of like I want to scream to everyone, to every person I know. Because every day, millions and millions of Black women, African women, women of color are wearing this synthetic hair, celebrating actually a cultural heritage that is dear to us, that was passed from generation to generation, which was a bond between a daughter and a mother. So imagine you're celebrating this cultural heritage and then you're being poisoned. It's not fair, honestly. So right now, if you have a sister, if you're a man and you're watching this, honestly, tell your sister to stay away from it. Everything is toxic, but things you can control, especially things you put on your body, especially things that you put on your body to stay for a man. Because this lady here, what she, her argument was, Rogers made a statement that actually to have an effect, you need to eat a bowl of hair at that moment to have actually like a reaction at that moment. But his argument is long-term exposure. Because you can imagine 7 years down the road. Because in most cases, I don't know anyone who did braids synthetic hair and removed it after 2 days. In most cases, it stayed for a month. For me, my story was different. Once I looked at the data, I was like, no. And also looked at my personal experience. I started seeing things that happened all over that period of time. Honestly, I think I'm screaming so hard for the kids out there, the kids you see every day. If you're putting this hair on kids, because remember their systems are not developed enough. 18 years from now, 20 years from now. If you're still consistently wearing this hair, from personal experience, because like before, when I look at myself growing up, like my hair was fine. And then I saw how bad it started going. And I was like, no. In case you're wondering, I'm putting on, this is plant-based hair. And it's funny enough that right now we have so many different products on the market. At least you will rather expose heat to your hair rather than the chemicals, because at least heat will just burn it out. And then you're fine. It doesn't grow. But at least it's better. At least it won't expose you to these endocrine disruptors. Because like right now, when you look at data, you see all the women in Africa, like history-wise, when you look down, African women were the most fertile women, but now we have infertility issues, things you put on your body every day. They shouldn't be harmful. Your body, you're scrubbed, because remember you have hair follicles, so it absorbs more. Why are we so trusting, honestly? Because any product you put on your kid's head and the head becomes like this, why would we trust without questioning? Our ancestors trusted people, the outcome wasn't good, but we're still trusting. And to this day, we still trust. You will see a product, they tell you, oh, this product does this, that. We don't even question what's used in this product. Because when you see the product on the African market, oh my God. Like you see all the chemicals that are banned here in Europe. It's really, really disheartening, honestly. And yet my people still trust, by the way. Today, we got companies producing for us product. These same people don't use the same product. Because if you go at Amazon actually and look at people who are producing the synthetic hair that we are wearing today, they are Chinese people. Chinese people don't wear these braids. So why are we so trusting that actually these people have our back? If you've been in East Africa, you'll find so many shops of Chinese downtown, like they are selling hair, synthetic hair like crazy. Your body is observant of the things you put on it. So I think the things we can at least try to control, the lesser chemicals we expose ourselves helps to release the toxins, the better. You can't say everything else is toxic in the world, so I can't do anything. Or you can't just get into your car and drive off and you're like, yeah, I might as well not put on a seatbelt because I may get an accident. No, you put on a seatbelt. So these are some of the things you need to start looking into, looking at the data. And also when you listen to your body will tell you. It will tell you the thing you're feeding me isn't right for me. It's not about being cheap. Cheap is expensive in the long run. At first, I bought human hair. I had that questioning, like, because you're carrying literally someone's DNA on your head. But it was better. I remember the time I treated it. It's the smell that I didn't like every time I would wash my hair, my braids. So my option would be go back to Uganda, carry a whole case of hair, and bring it here that will last for a year. And once it's done, I'll go back and get more. And right now the options are available. The option of wearing human weights, and that's also an option. And then human hair braids. But of course, it's very expensive because the good hair type at least will go for 100 euros and above. And most people can't afford that. That's not a good feeling. It's something like I just feel like, oh my God, I wish I could do something about it. And one good part is that most of the kids, the hair is cut actually throughout primary until high school. That's a good advantage. And then some people won't take their things seriously. And I know I've been there. I think it takes time to get synthesized, to believe things and to know actually the things are bad for me, which is really interesting. Like, you can't really actually tell someone who is not ready, like, to switch, to start looking at all the details. But if you get it, you'll get it. For me, what's important is coming here and actually talking about it. But I know because I've worked with someone who does production in this hair. Like, he's a manufacturer, he does produce so many products, which include of course hair production. But do really people know? If I hadn't met him and then dug deep, and then I would probably ignore the signs I was facing myself. And now I can't tell you I did this hair. Like, I did this hair 2 days. No, actually, it's when did I do it? It was on Saturday, and today's Monday. This hair, I've never prayed here in my life and slept in a night. I'd never, no itching, nothing. It's so light when you put it on. It's very light, and you can see it's a lot of hair, but it's a lot of hair when you see on my head. But too light. I'm not gonna suffer. What's that disease? I'm not gonna suffer from this. Because the hair is so light, it's not going to pull your scalp. It's easy, it doesn't itch, not at all. And I'm not someone who does even oil, but I feel like it's not drying. Synthetic hair would be drying to my hair. And the last time I removed my hair, you can really tell a difference. The hair was so healthy, it felt healthy. But with synthetic hair, oh my goodness, you should have looked at the hair, how it looked like. It looked so pretty. You could really tell that synthetic hair was really pulling everything from my hair. But we all start from somewhere, especially if your mom keeps synthetic hair away from your kids. So should you make that switch? Honestly speaking, if you care about your health, your body, yes, you should. No itch, no burn, not even a single time did I scratch my head. Honestly, nothing. Feels clean, it's crazy. But rating it, probably you have trouble with your salonists or stylists. My stylist was like, oh my God, this hair is so dry, it's so hard. And I'm like, come on, a salad is always not a good option, but it's better, it's gesund. So people are gonna tell you, oh, this hair is gonna take longer, it's not so soft. Of course it's not so soft because there are no chemicals to make it soft like synthetic. At the end of the day, if you choose plant-based, if you choose human hair, know your why. In other words, don't let someone talk down to you. And she's super expensive, and then she's complaining, yet I'm paying her. Of course, also the hair comes expensive compared to synthetic, but at the end of the day, your health is more important. It's the peace of mind that I feel right now. No itch, no burn, nothing, no pain. It's light, it's clean. So for me, I would choose that any day instead of a Gucci bag. And let me know know if you're still stuck with the synthetic hair or human hair. Let me know your journey and what you think. And also for people who've been interested, I will link for you a PDF. Anyone that is interested to check out all the chemicals they should avoid in their hair products. So I hope it will be a saver because I've really learned a lot along the way. If you're interested, find the PDF in the description. Check the chemicals that you have to try to avoid as a person. Otherwise, let's meet in the comments. Until next time, bye bye for now.